back in a time where safety was ignored. And steering in sleds was neglected. The designs of the past have been unsuccessful.
Original designs such as these have a 30% chance of giving children head injuries, and among those 30%, 10% of those will have permanent damage.
So a new sled emerges from the needs of the people.
Hi, Mr. Michelson. I'm interviewing you today just to hear your take on sleds.
Actually, it's Dr. Michelson. I got a doctorate in sledding from UC Santa Cruz. Go banana slugs. My take on sleds are they need to be durable. They cannot crack. Sleds need to be built to last. We can't have any mishaps.
Hi, Mr. McDonald. I'm interviewing you for just your take on what you want in a sled.
Well, as a father of three, whenever I do have custody of my children, I look for safety as one of my main factors when choosing a sled, because after all, my kids are the most important thing in my life, second to gambling. I also like whenever I can steer a sled. I don't like crashing into trees and getting brain damage. Oh, you could already see it. I don't like getting brain damage every time I try and sled, so that's also something very important to me.
Okay, thank you.
The Jamaican Bobsled Team introduces.
Our team of highly skilled first-year engineers have reinvented the classic sled to offer a safer, more steerable design that has unique features, setting the product apart from its leading competition.
Our solution was to build a design that checked off all the boxes of our stakeholders.
Now to introduce what you've all been waiting for, the Ice Shredder 4200.
With neoprene rubber padded seating.
Foot controlled steering.
Adjustable backpack straps.
Adjustable steering.
Flexheel and force bottom for durability.
In backpack straps that can be removed for your convenience.
Our problem matters because after interviewing our stakeholders about the problems they have with sleds, we base our design off of their suggestions. The sled was built by not only the students here at Mines, but also people who have all experienced sledding as a young child.
Our very distinguished stakeholders also desire to pay around $20 to $30 if the sled were to contain safety and durability features.
When designing the sled, we intended to keep it around the same price point as a normal sled so stakeholders would be more inclined to purchase the safer option. We did a fairly good job when doing this given that the safer sleds with the same idea as ours tend to cost around $100 or more.